Rahman Rahim, in the name of Allah, the most beneficent, the most merciful. The shortest distance between a problem and its solution is the distance between your knees and the floor. Turn to Allah before you turn to dust. So read word of Allah, understand and practice. It is Quran from Allah. Now today we will discuss skill lab pathology, and in this skill lab we will going to discuss the intracellular accumulations, pigments. So first of all, we know what are pigments, from where they come. Now pigments are inherently colored substances. In pathological pigmentation, there is deposition of colored substances at abnormal location, or there is deposition of colored substances in excess at normal locations. Pigments can be exogenous or endogenous. Endogenous pigments are further subdivided into hemoglobin derived, and others are non-hemoglobin derived. Hemosiderin, bilirubin and bilirubin are hemoglobin derived, and lipofuscin, melanin and homogentisic acids are non-hemoglobin derived pigments. Now hemosiderin is the main brown colored pigment derived from the hemoglobin. Hemoglobin is normal constituent of red blood cell. Now today we will discuss hemosiderin deposit. Hemosiderin can be deposited locally or generalized. Local deposition of hemosiderin, the common example is bruise. And in generalized deposition of hemosiderin, it lead due to common is multiple transfusion in case of hemolytic anemia. Now when there is bruise, there is injury, there is rupture of the blood vessels, which lead to accumulation of the blood, and there is red blue discoloration followed by greenish, then yellowish brown, and then after 14 days the skin is back to normal. Now the clinical scenario, usually bruise is formed when there is intact skin after injury from a fall. The common example is fall from a height, for example a tree, swelling, and there is yellow discoloration when the overlying skin is intact. Now how would you explain color changes at the site of swelling? Because whenever there is blood accumulation, there is bluish red discoloration, then it is broken down into heme and protein, then biliverdin is formed, then bilirubin, and then hemosiderin, and then hemosiderin is removed by the macrophages. So bruise is defined as a localized accumulation of extravasated blood from injured blood vessels with intact overlying skin. Now the features which support the diagnosis are history of fall, intact skin, swelling and discoloration. Because there are almost 2 weeks, the completely skin is back to normal. Now in the next video we will discuss generalized hemosiderin deposition. Thank you for watching. Subscribe the channel, like and share the video.